The Victorian Premier has secured controversial new powers after a pandemic management bill passed through Parliament following lengthy debate and protests. Critics of the bill include the opposition, with some MPs vowing to repeal it if elected next year. On the last sitting day of Victorian Parliament, and after a marathon final debate,
it's starting to feel like Groundhog Day.
We all want this to be over as soon as possible.
The proposed pandemic management legislation is now entrenched in law, having cleared Victoria's upper house and the Legislative Assembly on Thursday night.
Ayes 20, noes 18, therefore ayes have it.
It means power will transfer from the Chief Health Officer to the Premier and Health Minister.
The framework we have in place is timely, proportionate, and indeed sets a new national benchmark.
To declare a pandemic and enforce restrictions.
There are still things that have to be done, rules that need to be in place. None of them will be on for a moment longer than they need to be.
The contentious bill had prompted protests outside Parliament House and inside as well.
You know, we need those checks. We need the balances, too much power for the government, too much power for the Premier, and we fought and fought and fought all the way through, but the government, with their four Labor voting independents, have forced it through.
The government has made some changes to the bill, including reducing penalties. The opposition is vowing to reverse the bill if elected next year.
We will repeal it. We will repeal it. We are very concerned about this bill.
United Australia chairman and mining magnate Clive Palmer has also responded, saying he plans to fight the legislation in court. The laws will come into effect from December 16.